Assalamualaikum and hello everyone. Okay, again, we still look at our section A question for PSPM SK06. So please, keep ready your mind map and your notes for chapter 12 until chapter 17. Kalau tak ada chapter 13 pun tak apa. Okay, so let's look for question 2012-13. Okay, so question 2. So, question 2 is basically from your chapter 12 lah, hydrocarbon. Okay, tapi dekat sini dia kenapa 2A dengan 2C? Sebab 2B tu is actually your introduction to organic chemistry. Again, for your yang PSPM SK025, introduction to organic chemistry is not considered lah. Okay, so dalam case ni, we're gonna arrange the alkene in order of decreasing. So, maknanya kalau decreasing, maknanya from the highest to your lowest boiling point. Okay, again, before you're gonna start explaining, what you have to do is actually you draw the structure itself. So, 2-2-dimethyl, hexene, 1-2-3-4-5-6, and then butene. Okay, and then once you have draw the structure, barulah you can look at the size of the carbon and then the branch itself. So, remember, okay, the higher, the bigger the size. Okay, the size tu kita mostly akan tengok pada carbon itself lah. So, kalau carbon dia lagi banyak, so it means that our boiling point is higher. Okay, tapi beza pula dengan branch. If we have branch ataupun substituent, we have lots of it, so our boiling point will be lower due to the low surface area. Okay, and then for question 2C, dia minta alkene with chlorine gas. So, for the reaction ni, so dia minta draw the structure of the product. So, walaupun dia tak kata form 2 monochlorinated product dekat sini. So, we have our major dengan we have our minor product lah. Okay, so draw the structure, name the mechanism. So, name the mechanism ni sama lah dengan type of reaction tu. Okay, so walaupun reaction ni adalah halogenation, tapi kalau name the mechanism dia adalah free radical substitution. Okay, so dia kata draw the most stable free radical form in this reaction. Okay, so contohnya question 3 ni, better kamu leave a gap dulu. So, you have to do question 4 dulu. So, even though dia minta reaction equation of the step for the formation of major product, sebenarnya it is easier untuk kamu buat lah step for each of the step. Initiation, propagation, termination. Okay, sebab ada, there's the step for the formation of major product ni, ada pada propagation one step, pada termination one step. Tapi just to make it easier, buat je lah 3-3 step ni. Sebab Mish rasa, of all the mechanism, free radical mechanism is the easiest one lah. But make sure draw it for our major product. Kita tak nak minor eh, nak major product. So that's why, awal-awal ni, kalau kamu dah salah depan ni, bawah ni semua salah. Okay, so bila kamu dah tulis, you have draw all the mechanism, barulah senang kita nak draw the most stable free radical form. Okay, so far that's for question 2. So now let's look for question 3. So question 3 is actually our chapter haloalkane dengan kita punya alcohol. So question 3A ni, dia kata give reason for each of the following statement. So dia ada 5 questions, so maknanya each question 1 mark lah. Okay, so let's look here. How to answer this question? Okay, so we have PSPM 2012-13. Okay, so dia kata dekat sini first adalah 1-butanol is less acidic than phenol. Okay, so again for acidity, what we're going to look at is actually about the apa ni, stability of your conjugate base. Okay, kat sini eh. So, acidity is determined by the stability of the conjugate based of your acid. So, first and foremost, what I would like to do adalah I would like to write down the equation lah. So, this is my acid, this is my conjugate base. So, sebab we have yang H ni, tak perlu buat plus H2O pun. Dia dissociate macam ni sahaja pun boleh. Okay, then what we have to mention, so bila dia kata 1-butanol is less acidic than phenol. Okay, sorry, kalau phenol dia akan dissociate to form phenoxide ion. Kalau kita punya alcohol akan form alkoxide ion. Tapi kalau dia specific lagi, because we have 1, 2, 3, 4 kan. So, because when we have 4 carbon, so nama dia butoxide ion lah. Okay, so bila kita kata dekat sini, 1-butanol is less acidic than phenol, what we're going to discuss is actually our ion itself. So, we have our phenoxide ion dengan butoxide ion. Again, for the acidity, is determined by the stability of our conjugate, of our conjugate base. So, maksud dekat sini, phenol ni lagi acidic than our 1-butanol. So, I want to explain this part. Okay, so first and foremost, we're going to discuss in terms of our conjugate base. So, misal kita lah, phenoxide ion is more stable than alkoxide ion. And why? It's actually stabilized by our resonance effect. So, this is actually the simplest term dia lah. Okay, so sebenarnya macam mana dia jadi stabil tu? It's actually when all the negative charge here, it's actually... apa ni? Sebenarnya oksigen ni tak suka negative charge dekat dia ni. But then sebab the negative charge is equally distributed between the carbon in benzene ring ni. So kita tengok first ni dekat oksigen, but then dekat carbon sini, carbon number 2 ni, carbon number 4 here, carbon number 2 belah sini pula. So what will happen when it's being equally distributed? So it helps to make our phenoxide ion ni more stable. So ayat simple dia kita akan cakap is that our phenoxide ion is stabilized by resonance effect. So that's the first one. The second one, we have our yang COH ni is actually our carboxylic acid. So how I'm gonna do it is actually I'm gonna draw the structure in expanded term. So I have 1 2 3 carbon, 1 2 3. Okay, carbon number 1 ada 3 of my hydrogen, yang carbon number 2 I have 1 hydrogen, 1 OH. So here OH and OH, and then here we have our carboxylic acid. Okay, but untuk the second one, CH3COC double bond O. Sebenarnya walaupun kita nampak dia CO macam ni sahaja, so contohnya kan, if I draw it CH3CO, kalau kamu buat macam ni eh. Okay, for your carboxylic acid, as you can see, adalah C double bond OOH. Lepas tu contohnya, kita senang nak tengok hint, carbon kita ni baru ada 1, 2, 3 bond. So maknanya ada lagi satu bond dekat sini lah, which is, it means that it's actually our carbonyl. Okay, tapi dia kata dekat sini, both of the compounds actually carboxylic acid. Tapi kenapa this one, the first one ni has higher boiling point? Okay, so sebab the first one ni, adanya hydrogen bonding in the between the carboxylic acid dengan between apa ni, carboxylic acid ada hydrogen bonding. Dekat our hydroxy ni ataupun OH group ni pun ada hydrogen bonding. Remember, hydrogen bonding mestinya adalah FH, OH ataupun NH. So OH kat sini ada hydrogen bonding, sini pun sebenarnya ada hydrogen bonding. So tapi dalam case of CH3COC COH ni, okay, dia ada hydrogen bonding based on our carboxylic acid. But then this is actually C double bond O. C double bond O ni is tak ada pun hydrogen bonding. So this C double bond O ni is actually a dipole-dipole force. Dipole-dipole force ni adalah specifically untuk polar molecule sahaja. So dalam kes ni, the first compound ni, we have two hydrogen bonding lah. Maksudnya we have more hydrogen bonding. Kalau yang ini, satu hydrogen bonding, satu dipole-dipole force. So again, kalau based on the strength of IMF, dia sebenarnya London force is the weakest. London force paling weakest. Lepas tu dipole-dipole, second yang tengah-tengah, and paling strong adalah hydrogen bond. So dalam kes ni, the first molecule ni has a higher boiling point. Mana? Has higher boiling point sebab dia punya force tu, intermolecular forces tu is stronger. Okay, why? Sebab CH3COH carboxylic acid ni contain OH group which can form more hydrogen between molecule. So sebab adanya extra lagi satu OH ni kan, sebab dulu ni ada both ada carboxylic acid that can form hydrogen bonding. Tapi dalam case this one, we have our OH tu pun yang boleh form hydrogen bond. So, untuk question number 3, dia kata 2-methyl-2-propanol cannot undergo oxidation. Okay, so when I draw it, dia adalah C-2-methyl-2-propanol. We have 3 carbon. Lepas tu, pada carbon number 2, we have our OH dan we have our CH3. Okay, so dia cannot undergo oxidation. Okay, why? Sebab, okay, jom kita tengok balik kan pada mind map kita. Sebenarnya kalau untuk alkohol, kat bawah ni. So, for the case of oxidation, tak kisahlah dia weak ke, dia strong oxidizing agent, tertiary alcohol ni takkan ada reaction lah. There's no reaction. So, there's no hydrogen of, there's no presence of H on your carbinol carbon. Okay, ataupun nak guna simple words je, boleh je kita cakap sebenarnya sebab 2-methyl-2-propanol is a tertiary alcohol. So, dia cannot lah undergo oxidation. Kalau primary secondary, we can form our... what do you call that? Our oxidation. Okay, next one. Dia kata 2-hexanol gives yellow precipitate with iodine and in NaO solution. So, what is actually this test? So, kita tengok balik pada nota chapter 15 kita. So, we have learned about a chemical test. So, iodine in NaO ni is actually our iodoform test. Okay, so what is the function of iodoform test ni? Okay. Dia mesti kena apa ni? Okay. Iodoform in our solution tu is called iodine test, which help to determine the presence of metal carbinol. Okay, metal carbinol ni, okay. Carbinol ni is actually this part. Okay. Carbinol ni is actually carbon yang ada OH. Carbinol COH. Kalau carbonyl, C double bond O. Kalau carbinol is COH. Okay, so and then the pada COH kita ni, mesti ada at least one of my CH3 lah. And then actually kena ada satu hydrogen dekat sini. Okay, so by then the function of iodine test ni is actually to determine the presence of metal carbinol. So, I'm gonna draw my two hexanol. So, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then pada carbon number 2 tu, tak kisah dua kat sini ke, dua sini pun boleh juga. I have my OH. Okay, so maknanya this is actually my apa ni, carbinol carbon lah. This is my carbinol carbon. So, pada carbinol carbon ni, attach pada dia, ada tak CH3? So, this is actually adanya presence of CH3 lah. Dia pada COH ni, dia bonded to CH3 satu, dia bonded pada hydrogen satu, dia bonded to C yang ada empat ni pun satu. Tapi kita tengok dia ada bonded to one of my CH3. So, that's why dia bagi positive result. So, we have to mention, ni jawapan dia. Two hexanol has metal carbinol group which give positive result. Okay, and then last but not least, question number 5. Dia bertanya, both phenol and one propanol react with sodium, but only phenol dissolve in aqueous aqueous sodium hydroxide. So, question ni pun sebenarnya kita ada tengok juga in previous year punya question. Okay, why? Okay, so sebab bila kita tengok, contohnya kita tengok dekat mind map kan, alkohol ni tak ada pun reaction dengan sodium hydroxide. Dengan sodium ada, tapi sodium hydroxide dia tak ada. Whereas, kalau kita punya phenol pula, kita tengok chapter 15 kita phenol ni pula ada react dengan OH. Okay. Why? So, there's a reason. Okay, sebab bila dia react dengan naung ni, it actually as a base. So, kalau base, dia nak react dengan, dia adalah acid-base reaction. So, apa ni? Phenol ni acidic, is acidic compound. So, sebab tu dia boleh react dengan sodium hydroxide. Kalau alcohol tu, it's not an acid. So, sebab tu lah dia tak boleh react dengan sodium hydroxide. Tapi apa lagi yang kita belajar? Carboxylic acid, dia nak tak react dengan naung. Dia nak. Sebab carboxylic acid is actually acid lah. Base, nama dia pun dah clear kan, is acid. Dia boleh nak react dengan base. Phenol pun nak react dengan base, tapi kalau alkohol tak boleh, dia tak nak react dengan base lah, sebab it's not an acid, so takkan undergo our neutralization reaction. Okay, so how to explain it? Kita just bagi tahu simple je. Okay, phenol is more acidic than 1-propanol. So that's why lah phenol boleh react dengan base, 1-propanol tak boleh react dengan base. Sebab dia more acidic, boleh form neutralization lah dengan base kita. 1-propanol cannot. Okay, so kita tengok sekarang ni for question. Kita tengok balik soalan. Okay, so for question B. So draw the structure of product B through F in the reaction below. Okay, so yang ini Miss rasa kamu boleh buat sendiri je. Okay, cuma yang ini je Miss nak discuss sikit. So, bila BR ni dengan KCN, what would happen is that kita akan undergo nucleophilic substitution between bromine dengan cyanide. So, bila bromine dengan cyanide ni, so what will happen adalah kita akan tukar dia punya position lah. So, sini akan jadi CN kita. Okay, so, lepas tu ni adalah question yang D ni, dia react dengan H2SO4. Dia sebenarnya samalah juga dengan H3O+. Yang ni macam tak biasa pula . Sebenarnya yang itu macam nota carboxylic acid kita. Sebab bila kita dah form kita punya CN. Okay, mana? So, sebab bila kita dah, contohnya tadi BR kan tadi react dengan KCN, akan substitute dengan cyanide. So, bila undergo hydrolysis akan form kita punya carboxylic acid. Okay, so that's for question. Untuk yang F, F ni Miss dah bagi tahu juga. Yang D ni pun Miss nak bagi tahu. Okay, why? Sebab jawapan dia dekat sini kan. Yang ini sebab, kenapa pula? Benzin. Okay, so dia form yang ni kan, CN. So, sebenarnya kalau kita tengok, CN ni dia ada go reaction dengan LiHa. si Leha ni, H3O+. So, Leha ni, okay, yang ini miss kena yang ni juga. Sebab ni sebenarnya, walaupun number 3 ni mostly chapter 14 dengan 15 kan, sebenarnya dia dah masuk admin dah. So, kita tengok sekejap nota chapter 18. Okay, so sebenarnya bila kita punya nitrile ni, kita reactkan dengan Lialhah ni, okay, we're gonna add 2 hydrogen to our C dengan our nitrogen. So, we're gonna form our amine. Dah banyak soalan, tiba-tiba ada soalan amine kan? Okay, so what will happen is that, so jawapan dia yang ni pun tolong lah. So, dekat sini, benzin lagi. So, sebenarnya CN ni adalah C triple bond N. C triple bond N. Tapi what happen adalah bila dia dah reduction ni, kita akan form 2 of our hydrogen tambah 2 hydrogen at each of the atom. Pada carbon ya, pada nitrogen pun ya. So we're going to form our amine. Okay. So question C. Ni kamu boleh buat. Okay. Ni show how you prepare alcohol G for, via Grignard reagent. Ini first and foremost, determine dulu class of alcohol. So, kenapa? Sebab kalau kamu masih ingat, nanti Miss bagi dekat link. Sebenarnya kita kena tahu from our primary alcohol. From our alcohol, sebenarnya kita boleh determine lah apa ni, what is actually the original carbonyl dengan Grignard reagent kita. So, yang ini pun kita dah banyak buat juga. Tapi tak apa, yang ni misalkan bagi link ni dekat kamu, so you could try yourself. Yang question 8, tadi tu question tu dalam primary alcohol kan? Nah, same lah dengan yang this part. Okay, so kita tengok balik pada PSPM. Okay, next adalah question number 4. So, reaction of the compound I are shown in the following scheme. So, here is actually, okay, number 4 ni kita punya carbonyl dengan our carboxylic acid. So, this is actually carbonyl kita, dia react dengan Nabiha H3O+. So, Nabiha ni, sodium borohydride ni, is actually our reducing agent. Where, selalu kita famous guna si Leha ni, Lialhah H3O+. Tapi boleh juga react dengan Nabiha, dengan H2 platinum pun boleh juga. Okay, so yang ini pun boleh tengok straightforward pada kamu punya mind map lah. Ni adalah chapter 16 punya mind map. So, what happen bila kita react dengan si Leha tu? Mana Leha? Leha boleh guna Nabiha boleh. So, sama sajalah. Okay, and then for that question yang apa ni nama dia? K ni pun you could do it yourself. Sebab dia adalah nah SO3, sebiji sahaja dalam mind map. So, dia tanya dekat sini, what is the nucleophile involved in the formation of G? So, sebab sebenarnya nanti, what will happen is that we're going to add our hydrogen. So, dekat sini kita akan tulis, our nucleophile involved adalah H. Tapi dalam kes ni, nucleophile adalah our negative charge. So, H minus. Which is our hydride ion. Terima je jawapan ni. Okay, so question 3. Suggest a chemical test to differentiate between I dengan J. So, I ni is actually our ketone. J ni akan kita akan form another test lah. Sebenarnya kita akan form our alcohol lah. So, banyak chemical test kita boleh guna. Sebab alcohol kita dah belajar Lucas test boleh. Lepas tu apa lagi kita belajar? Kalau determine the presence of C double bond O adalah kita punya Brady's test. Okay, if you be unsure, Lucas ni dekat chapter 15. Brady's ni dekat chapter 16. Tengoklah mana-mana test yang kamu nak guna. Okay, and then dia kata dekat sini, show how I can be synthesized from alkyl halide containing 9 carbon atom. So, I ni is actually our C, kita punya, apa, what do you call that? Our ketone. So, macam mana nak jawab yang ini? Kita tengok balik ni. Okay, so this is actually our I. So, this is actually our I. Okay, kalau Miss tengok kan sebenarnya, lepas tu dia from an alkyl halide. Okay, so, bila sebenarnya Miss nampak 9 carbon atom kan, sebenarnya 9 carbon atom tu sebenarnya kita tengok ni 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, here is my 9 carbon atom. So, originally tak banyak ubah lah. Okay, so our last product is actually our ketone. Tapi first product kita adalah alkyl halide. So, first apa yang Miss nak buat adalah Miss nak, maknanya C double bond O ni akan dimove kan. Mestilah alkyl halide kita lah. Tapi kat sini dah ada extra lagi hydrogen sebab carbon make sure kena ada 4 bond. Carbon sini memang ada 4 bond dah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tapi bila kita kat sini, originally, this is our alkyl halide. Tapi sebenarnya, alkyl halide ni mana boleh terus jadi keton? Sebab sebenarnya kalau keton, kalau kita nak form keton, mostly adalah from our alcohol. So, from our halo alkene ni, Miss nak form our alcohol macam mana? Adalah boleh guna NaOH ataupun H2O pun boleh. So, what we're gonna do, we're gonna substitute our Cl dengan our OH. Okay, so akan form our alcohol. So, alcohol, this is actually our secondary alcohol. Sebab dua alkyl group kan attached. So, when it undergo oxidation, akan form kita punya keton. So, cation of OH plus heat boleh. Weak oxidizing agent pun boleh juga. Okay, so that's for question number 4. Okay, and then kita tengok last but not least is question B. So, dia kata, arrange the following compound in ascending order of acidity. Explain your answer. So, sebelum ni kita banyak tengok kalau acidity alcohol dengan phenol kan? Contohnya dekat question ni sendirilah kita ada banyak explain pasal acidity. Tapi contohnya kalau untuk carboxylic acid ni, nanti Miss akan bagi link untuk yang acidity for carboxylic acid. First and foremost, what we're going to look at untuk acidity pada your carboxylic acid ada tak electron withdrawing group? Okay, so contohnya kita tengok dekat sini. Sini ada. Okay, lepas tu mostly adalah. Ada apa ni? 1, 2, 3 ni ada electron withdrawing group. Next, kita tengok factor dia, how many yang dia ada. So, sini ada 1, 2, yang ini ada 2. Lepas tu, kita kena tengok factor dia lah position. So, position dia lah, ni 2 chlorobutanic acid, 4 chlorobutanic acid ni macam mana. So, you have to draw it lah. Okay, so macam mana nak compare, I believe you could try yourself. Tengok balik pada video tu macam mana. Okay, tapi yang satu sahaja, kalau between, if anything, memang carboxylic acid kita is more acidic than our alcohol. Alcohol ni sebab roh lah. Okay, so maknanya dalam case ni, dia nak ascending order of acidity. So maknanya, we're gonna start with the least acidic. So the least acidic is actually our alcohol, 1 butanol. Lepas tu compare lah, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this 4 is actually compared in terms of 3 factor here. Sebab tu lah Miss kata nanti Miss akan bagi playlist untuk yang carboxylic acid tu. Sebab I believe yang itu straightforward sahaja. So, that's it for PSPM 2012-13.